Holding on your rope got me 10 feet off the ground. And I'm hearing what you say, but I just can't make a sound. You tell me that you need me, then you go and cut me down. But wait, you tell me that you're sorry, didn't think I'd turn around.
All right, hey, Kyle Martin, Town Revive. We're near downtown Dallas, actually, and so we just decided to go talk about the Word of God, 1 Samuel 15, about how Saul was specifically disobedient to what God asked him to do. Now, we're just going to use real-life scenarios, real-life stories, in hopes that we can connect this story to ultimately the gospel. Let's go find some people that we can talk to. Where are you going, first of all?
To the house.
To the house. Where are you going?
Garland.
To Garland. All right. We're talking to some fine ladies here, just going on a stroll. Nice sunny afternoon. Well, sunny morning.
Sunny morning.
Question for you is have you ever heard of the guy named King Saul?
I heard of King Solomon.
Solomon's in the Bible.
He is.
So is Saul.
He's a king too.
Yeah. Ever heard of the guy?
Never heard of him.
Never heard of him.
Yeah. They hear them on TV and radio, and you hear them on Facebook. I said
it's too late to fall. Here's the story, and this leads to the question, all right?
Go ahead.
I like you. Hey, look at our boots. We're true Texans, aren't we? This is the most quick version of 1 Samuel 15 you'll ever heard in your life. Bullet point version. Through a prophet Samuel, he tells Saul, you got to do something. You got to take care of all your enemies. Wipe them out. Men, women, children, infant, and all the animals. So Saul, I don't know what's so funny. Saul then decides to go do that, except he keeps one enemy alive, the king, and a couple of the animals. Just based on that story, do you think Saul was obedient or disobedient to what he was told to do?
You know, it's kind of hard to say he was obedient or he was disobedient.
He was probably disobedient.
He was disobedient. That's kind of obvious, right?
Yes.
That obvious?
Yeah, I wouldn't do it.
You wouldn't do it?
I wouldn't kill nobody. For what?
Okay. All right, now I have no idea where you stand with religion, faith, but do you ever feel like God has told you to do something and you just didn't fully do it?
Yes.
Yes.
Probably, yeah. Yeah. If he was, you know, to tell me to do something and I didn't listen, it was probably for a very good reason.
But you know, and Saul thought that too.
Yeah.
And then he got his kingship taken away from him. So do you think there's a higher power?
Absolutely. I mean, we wouldn't be going through the things that we're going through if we didn't have somebody looking over.
Okay, so let's just imagine that I'm a prophet from God, okay? Just go along with me. He sent me to talk to you and say, this is what you need to do to have a hope and a future in life. I'm going to spell it out for you. So it says that while you and I were still doing those things, Christ died for us. What's keeping you from saying, Jesus, this is it today?
There's nothing stopping you. You know, keep going. It's just when you got that time is that you want to go right there.
Think it's going to be in a week?
Nah, I don't think it's going to be in a week, but it'll be soon.
You are the type of a person that needs a pat on the back and a kick in the rear. Good job, and what are you waiting for? Yeah. Lord God, I thank you for this brother. Thank you for who he is and the fact that his heart and his mind are soft and open to the truth. May he embrace Jesus as his Lord and Savior in your timing. In Jesus' name, amen.